Now we discussed the very short and the last section of this chapter. This is the electric field of a dipole. So we have earlier the equation for a dipole is that V of a dipole is a function of R. We have written it is a function of R. Now we will consider the complete coordinates. So I am writing it is a function of R in theta, and this is because only the R and theta are involved there. It is free from the pi coordinate, and this was equal to R unit vector and P and divide over 4 pi epsilon naught and R squared. So this is equal to P cos theta divide by 4 pi epsilon naught and R squared. So is only R and theta are involved, so I have written it like this. Now let's consider the coordinate system, and the coordinate system is such that we are having a dipole. Now the dipole placed here, and its dipole moment is along the z axis. So these are the r theta phi coordinates, and now I know that to find the electric field from a potential, then we know the equation that electric field is basically the negative gradient of potential. So this negative gradient of potential I am going to find out, and this I will find in the spherical polar coordinates. So here I am writing the components of this is about the radial component in the gradient form. This is equal to minus 1 r curly over curly r partial r and v. So taking the derivative of this with respect to r and putting a minus sign, so it will become minus p cos of theta and divide over 4 pi epsilon naught in r cube, r square, because 1 over r square derivative will come out to be minus 2 p and cos of this. So 1 minus is here and 1 minus here, because the derivative of this 1 over r square is curly by curly r, it is minus 1 over r cube, and 2 comes here, minus 2 over r cube. So minus minus become plus here, and we have this thing equal to p, or let me write 2p, because 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught we will use. So 2p cos of theta over 4 pi epsilon naught r cube. So I have written the same thing here. Similarly, the theta component of this one, of the gradient, is equal to minus 1 over r and curly v r partial v by partial theta. So we will now differentiate this with respect to theta, and cos theta derivative is minus sine theta. So minus from here and minus here will become plus. So we will have p of sine theta divide by, and 1 r here and 1 r square here, so it will become 4 pi epsilon naught in r cube. Similarly, the third component, which is e phi, is, we know there is no dependence. E phi is basically minus 1 over r sine theta and partial v over partial phi. But as v is not depending on phi, so this thing is equal to 0. So we have the electric field of a dipole in terms of r and theta is equal, and this is, I will write this in a vector form. This is equal to, now I will have to write, because with this one, this is the component. So ER in R unit vector, E theta in theta unit vector. So I will write those things here, and this will be P over 4 pi epsilon naught in R cube here, and this will come out to be 2 cos theta, 2 cos theta, and it's in R unit vector, plus sine theta in theta unit vector, divide by this, the same thing. So this is basically the electric field of a dipole. In here I can see that the electric field is varying is 1 over r cube, because when the potential is varying of a dipole is 1 over r square, so the electric field will be is 1 over r cube, because there is one r difference here with this one. There is a very, very familiar problem, which is problem 3.33. Problem 3.33. This one is very important and very typical problem. And this problem basically is saying that prove that the electric field, this is in a coordinate form, because we have written as in R unit vector and theta unit vector. Now the problem is asking to write this electric field in a coordinate free form, and prove that this will come out to be is electric field of a dipole function of R will come out to be 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and 1 over r cube, and this is 3 p dot r unit vector, and r along r unit vector minus p. So this is the coordinate free form, like we are not writing in r unit vector or theta unit vector, only a function of this one. So is you know that how to convert this thing, means how to write the theta unit vector in the form of r unit vector and then simplify this thing. So I hope you will be able to do it, and with this we are done with chapter 3 of the DJ Griffiths, and soon we will start with the chapter 4 as well. So far we are done with this chapter. So thank you for watching this, and I will appreciate your comments. If you are having any question, you can ask in the comments, and I will try to respond quickly to that one as much as possible.